Watching yet again, people thanking the bus driver. It's time to get started.
Halfway through Heat 2. Can we get some noise here if you're here in San Jose at TwitchCon? Please!
Oh, yeah.
There we go.
Oh, yeah.
The Battle Bus taking off. I like that the Fort Nightmares decoration on it, Jack. I think it's really cool. Kind of makes the top look like a mummy.
Every time they've had a theme to the Battle Bus, it's been awesome.
With the exception of I heard complaints about the Happy Birthday one because that song got embedded in people's heads. I loved it, just saying.
It was super, super catchy.
It was.
Super, super catchy.
I heard it in my sleep. I want you to know that. Now, that's talked about
weird.
Tilted.
People are going there.
First time thus far in Heat 2, looks like we're going to have two teams. One's landing down at the pawn shop, the other team splitting the north side in half, east and west. We have a pretty even spread. We have people at Leaky Lake. We have Pleasant Park occupied. Potentially so far, the only spot that hasn't really been touched is just because people haven't landed there. We have a team stretching to Lucky. Risky's gonna be occupied. Tomato. You have a team kind of awkwardly floating between Lazy Lynx and Risky, checking to see if it's a safe zone, so they're gonna land at that cluster of houses to the west of Risky. The hotel sharing space, coexisting. Ooh. As shots come out, and Shadow is down to 68 HP already. Not a whole lot to his name. He's got a close-up set, weapon set here. Looking for that six-shooter headshot. Moon gets knocked. That elimination will most likely happen relatively quickly, and there it is. Animal Crow saying, we're not going out first this time, Jack.
I was gonna say, remember,
we're not going out first this time.
Earlier, they were eliminated right off the break, and he's just staring down these two players that are inching closer and closer.
Bogging.
Are they going? We're about to have a second engagement. They could have four limbs instantly off the break of this one if they can survive this, but look at how weak they are. And this is the difference in play. Look at how aggressive they're getting. Trying to push on forward. They don't get the knock. Animal with one down. It's a quick little trade. Bogdan has such a health advantage here. If he loses this fight,
with the weapon setup,
it will be disastrous.
One shotgun shot. If they end up getting on top of each other, Bog doesn't have a shotgun.
He doesn't have a lot of materials either. Does he see a shotgun right there or just ammo? I think that might have been just ammo. One player
top
close.
Down SMG spray from above.
He's taken 19 damage so far. Keep in mind just how weak this opponent is. Now down to 93. Now down to 55. Oh,
ooh.
And the hip fire.
You can see him mouthing, let's go.
That's huge. The Sentinel players now down again. That's two games landing now at Motel that they've gone out in the opening 60 seconds. Rockets getting shot out as well. There is a res, so they'll know both are back up. But still, will they be able to push the advantage now? Interesting thing to note, that was Fariko's last sniper shot. He's out of heavy ammo. So he clutch shot up, Zill popping the medkit. Will he get it off in time? Here comes the build battle now. A 1v2 build fight. Dark Ops playing the low ground for the moment. He's trying to break down his opponent to force him down to the low ground yet again. He doesn't have many mats left, so that's his reaction to it. Fariko dropped down to under 10 HP. Another one falls all the way down to the ground. It looks like he's going to match the fall as well. Building back on up. The nerves these players must be feeling as they know everything's on the line in these games. Fariko now knocked. Zill returns the sniper knock favor right there. And Dark Ops and Fariko, they went for it. They wanted to get aggressive. Now they get rocketed, and that's a worst case scenario. They thought they had the opening. A quick pickup from Harrians to pick up Zill. The med kit was popped as well, and they wind up swinging that fight in their favor.
They don't want to push out too early. If they push early, they see from above, shots are going to happen. They're going to go for tags at any elim they can get while Salt and his teammate are rotating. But if they time it and they wait until the same moment, it cuts the risk of getting tagged at all significantly. Zill, Harrian's just waiting here inside the zone, basically smack dab in the middle here. He's watching, you see that. Zekstro and Vinny.
Oh! What was that?
A shot.
Vinny now trying to save his teammate. Zekstro now knocked. They're playing edit battles around these walls. I'm assuming Vinny's gonna try to get in the same box as Zekstro to be able to build in front of him, protect him. Yeah, there you go. He wants to claim this as his own, doesn't get it. Quick edit comes in, tags him for 40. Both players now weak. That's already been edited. Nice job with the ramp though, to at least give himself cover for the moment. Will he try to hop on three? Places an ice trap. It's not what he wanted. Oh, and he's skating all around.
Grenade ricochet zone. If you sit down there at the bottom, down in the river.
This is from Nikiski earlier. One, two.
Teammate Spades gets knocked there. But it's no big deal.
And this is how those third parties.
It's like Space does get eliminated there.
That was
the shot
dirty.
The very last second.
Wait, so we got four limbs during all this? That is nuts. So you see here, look. It's like he wanted to go and he places that pyramid down to make the so a ramp can't be placed by his opponent. It's a great, great little build right there. You can then control that edit as well and mess with your opponent too.
Still trying to time a snipe on a fight that's happening to the northwest. Looks like they're going to make a move here. A lot of structures being built up, and now's the time to plan your drop. Just kind of scanning. You see they're dipping back and forth in the air, trying to avoid getting shot by anybody that'll sneak in underneath another team here. Build up their own little base. They're going to create a couple little structures here. The pyramids above, reinforcing the ceilings. Somebody is taking a shot in from the side. Another team edits a hold of the window. Zill takes a shot from above as he's trying to layer up against this. His teammate, Harian's taking shots with him. They've got to just push back. More layers, more layers, more layers. Try and not get tracked. I was going to say, it wouldn't surprise me if a couple ramps started popping up as additional layers of structure between that opponents would have to push through. Pops through the window there. Harian's still just firing down on the wall. Looking for any tags, especially if they see white damage tags. You know, at that point, continuing to spray a structure isn't a bad call if they're pushing for just another elim. Maybe another point is one away there. Kind of looking through the structure that's been built up by their opponents to the northeast, down a few layers. Looks like a fight is happening, and wish you luck. Gets eliminated in the feed there by Tyrone. 48 left. This circle closes in 8 seconds.
Harians and Zeal trying to rack these limbs up. I'm confident in these guys potentially being able to go for a big bonus this game. But now this is where it gets insane. If we can we pull back up that map real quick? Of the next zone. It is on the opposite side of this mountain.
They move all the way
through Shifty.
On the back side
of Shifty.
You see it on the top right.
So like everyone's got to make some sort of move either over this mountain or through Shifty Shafts. Look at how awkward this
is
about to be. Because of this elevation, the elevation changes everything.
46 players at this point. They're waiting. At this point, they're already gonna be at the edge of the circle. We've got an opponent caught outside. Crypt could not get the attachment with that grappler, trying to get any sort of distance. Couldn't do it. The elimination, he ticks out there. Imperial Hound trying to move up.
Look at these builds at the mountain. It's a mad chase to try to get on up.
Half the eliminations of the feed right now are either to the storm or Pain
eliminates
himself.
He missed the shot. They still got 5 elims, so 2 points for them. Great, great stuff. Some big fall damage taken there. Amaze now knocked. Navi down to just 47 actual health, so the storm could be his biggest enemy here in the coming moments. And they look at how far he still has to travel. It's time to use the grappler, he says, as he's trying to get the high ground. Nothing as of yet. Stuck inside these builds. It's just so awkward going up. I'm telling you, that low of HP, it spells disaster. And look at this view of everyone scaling the mountain. So many players. Look at how low health so many of these players are, because they've all been taking storm damage.
Looks like it missed all that. Poach is still up. I saw him, his name still wiggling around. That entire structure coming down. Landjock and Takata maybe trying to take advantage of that.
And now it goes back across.
He knocks himself with a rocket.
Rough.
Caught off guard by that pyramid directly
way
in
the
front
road.
Of him. Clipped the edge of it. It is indeed.
See, now Mazerwind and Static have made it above the mountain. Look at these grapplers everywhere. Everyone's just soaring through the air. This is how you get over these awkward, you know, high ground zones on these mountains.
Static takes the cat out with a rifle shot there. Static and Mazerwind building as high as they can.
He's out of materials. He didn't realize. He was trying to go for all these crazy edits. Now he's just stuck up in the sky. The low ground so stacked with players. Everyone tagged, everyone weak. Mazer and Static seem to have the best positioning possible.
14 players left right now, too.
And you just saw for a brief moment the frustration on Poach's face.
Nolan in the feed eliminating Kevy. Static, Mazerwind still have this top-down view on pretty much
everybody
12
left.
Fall.
Yeah, they have no mats.
That glider deploy mechanic coming in big right there, but super exposed. No builds basically meant he had to land in the open.
And think if he had builds right there, how easy that would have been. He would have just been farming from up top. Quick Elim comes in. 9 now left. Mazerwind still with 0 limbs this game. Teammate Static, who we just saw drop. He wants to try to pop these medkits. One player just above. He can't build a single wall.
As soon as he heard that trap, it looked like someone was directly underneath him, placed a trap and an attempt to get him dropped down. Falls down, finds Lamar hiding.
Five left, they make it four. Caliber trying to bounce around and stay inside this zone. He's got no materials either. Everyone running out. He's falling down the side. One player just on his edge. I don't think they can build either. He's got no place to land. There he goes. Arts up top. Three players remaining. The shot comes in. Tendons with the elim.
1v1 situation here.
Versus one. Where is he?
Lamar healing.
He's popping
a medkit all the way outside the zone.
Lamar is all the way in the zone healing.
If he lands this and Tendons has no heals.
Oh my gosh, he got the medkit. Now he's firing down. They're trying to get the shots down range. No builds can happen. He's down to 37, 29, 21, 13. No, the tree of life. As Tendons hides. And it keeps him alive with just 15 hit points.
That
favorite tree in all of Fortnite. Look at this. No builds. He was getting sprayed down at. It was his last ditch effort. He had no other option. Oh, he grappled. Did he grapple to the tree? Stop. Is that what happened? Oh, look at that.
Are you kidding me?
Wow. Those bullets whizzing by. One more shot. The tree was done for. I am almost certain. Look at this. Watch this last bullet just whiz past. Oh, one more round.
Are you kidding
me? One more
me?
Round that I think it was done for. Here it is again. Oh, look at our standings. Way, way different point values from what we saw earlier. Tfue and Cloak had 15 points, right, when they were in first place?
Exactly.
First place after three games here has six. So, seriously, you can get, if you get a victory royale with seven elims, that's 6 points. You could have zero right now.
And you could still end up moving on to Sunday.
Yes.
There's one game left for Heat 2.
Yep.
You have a lot of teams, like you said, that are sitting under the required points. Do you go out of your way at this point? Because on top of that, you still have the big bonus. So if you have a crazy high elimination count, especially early game, if you watch for a drop where maybe there's is a high population, let's say Paradise or Retail or something like that, it has a lot of players going there.
Oh my God. Poach and Vivid are the wild card. Poach and Vivid right now. This, it all comes down to this for them.
Do you play aggressive? What do you do, Jack?
Poach and Vivid are on the chopping block.
Bibby, let's say this carries over to the next match. That means either the boys here from Liquid or...